stops.
Yeah.
Speed.
Miranda, here we go again.
Mm-hmm.
It's getting to be a regular thing, and I'm loving it.
Let's hope so.
You know, I'm when I talk with you, of course, in interviews, you're always with your very proper, beautiful English accent. And then this movie comes along, The Evening Star, and you come on screen and you open your mouth. It's a Texas accent that won't quit.
Sure.
I mean, where and how did you perfect that accent?
Great dialect coach. Tribute to her, and I hope to work with her again. And it was fun, you know? I mean, this is a delicious character, and it's a chance to be expansive and open in a very different way to stuff I've done before. You know, there's all that sort of heat and dust in that voice, and all the accumulation of years and marriages and failures and triumphs and stuff. It's all sort of in there, you know.
I suspect there are excuse me. I suspect there are a couple of Texas and Houstonian socialites down there who can really identify with your character.
Well, we're not naming any names.
Did you meet any of them?
I met people who would move in the same kind of social sphere as Patsy, but Patsy is not based on any one or several particular people. You know, it's you kind of bring it in. I don't know how to explain it, really. You kind of bring it in from all sorts of areas, really. You know, and you can see people when you're out shopping and in restaurants who might have something of Patsy there, you know. And certainly the external stuff, like the hair and the nails, and it's very, very prevalent there, and wonderful clothes, and, you know, you see them all around.
What else impressed you about Houston and Texas?
Really? Oh, the I love the museums there in Houston. I had a very good time looking around there when I did have some time off. The hospitality is, as they say, you know, it's the Southern hospitality. It's just right there, the fantastic manners and care about your comfort. So that's very much there.
Did you all stay in a hotel, or did you stay...
Apartments.
Yes. How about the food? Did you...
I love that food. I had a couple of happy evenings in some very fine Houston restaurants. Thank you very much. Yes, memorable.
Did you get into the Tex-Mex food?
Yeah, I did.
You liked it?
I do. I do very much.
Of course... A person who travels as much as you do, I guess you get accustomed to trying different kinds of food. Because you don't have Tex-Mex in England, surely.
Yes, we do, but I don't think we do it very well. It hasn't caught on in the same way. But I think it's nice to have an injection of that fire into our chilly climate, you know, sometimes. I mean, I came back from Louisiana recently, and the first thing I did was cook Southern for all my friends, because I'm so bad at sending postcards. So I decided to give them a taste of where I'd been instead. And that seemed to work very well.
I was amazed at Fortnum & Mason's, where you can find all of this different kind of food, Tex-Mex food that you can make in your own kitchen.
Well, people are traveling so much more anyway now. They want these experiences. Why shouldn't we be able to get them where we are, you know? And we saw it, the European stuff, a lot of people have been moving between, say, France and England or Italy and England, and they want the same things that they can buy there in England when they're in England, because they miss them, you know.
Well, I wish I could move Fortnum & Mason here. I love that
Start
story.
One up. Yeah.
Miranda, again, congratulations on your performance. It is right on.
Thank you.
And I'm a Texan. I know when...
I know.
I know when it's right on.
Right.
And I'll look forward to the next time, whenever, wherever. Meanwhile, have very happy holidays.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're dressed for Christmas already.
Yes, well, see...
Crazy. Pull out the stops.
Yeah. Miranda, here we go again.
Mm-hmm.
It's getting to be a regular thing, and I'm loving it.
Let's hope so.
You know, I'm when I talk with you, of course, in interviews, you're always with your very proper, beautiful English accent. And then this movie comes along, The Evening Star, and you come on screen and you open your mouth. It's a Texas accent that won't quit.
Sure.
I mean, where and how did you perfect that accent?
Great dialect coach. Tribute to her, and I hope to work with her again. And it was fun, you know? I mean, this is a delicious character, and it's a chance to be expansive and open in a very different way to stuff I've done before. You know, there's all that sort of heat and dust in that voice, and all the accumulation of years and marriages and failures and triumphs and stuff. It's all sort of in there, you know.
I suspect there are excuse me. I suspect there are a couple of Texas and Houstonian socialites down there who can really identify with your character.
Well, we're not naming any names.
Did you meet any of them?
I met people who would move in the same kind of social sphere as Patsy, but Patsy is not based on any one or several particular people. You know, it's you kind of bring it in. I don't know how to explain it, really. You kind of bring it in from all sorts of areas, really. You know, and you can see people when you're out shopping and in restaurants who might have something of Patsy there, you know. And certainly the external stuff, like the hair and the nails, and it's very, very prevalent there, and wonderful clothes, and, you know, you see them all around.
What else impressed you about Houston and Texas?
Really? Oh, the I love the museums there in Houston. I had a very good time looking around there when I did have some time off. The hospitality is, as they say, you know, it's the Southern hospitality. It's just right there, the fantastic manners and care about your comfort. So that's very much there.
Did you all stay in a hotel, or did you stay?
Apartments.
Yes. How about the food? Did you?
I love that food. I had a couple of happy evenings in some very fine Houston restaurants. Thank you very much. Yes, memorable.
Did you get into the Tex-Mex food?
Yeah, I did.
You liked it?
I do very much.
Of course, a person who travels as much as you do, I guess you get accustomed to trying different kinds of food, because you don't have Tex-Mex in England, surely.
Yes, we do, but I don't think we do it very well. It hasn't caught on in the same way, but I think it's nice to have an injection of that fire into our chilly climate, you know, sometimes. I mean, I came back from Louisiana recently, and the first thing I did was cook Southern for all my friends, because I'm so bad at sending postcards. So I decided to give them a taste of where I'd been instead, and that seemed to work very well.
I was amazed at Fortnum & Mason's, where you can find all of this different kind of food, Tex-Mex food that you can make in your own kitchen.
Well, people are traveling so much more anyway now. They want these experiences. Why shouldn't we be able to get them where we are, you know? And we saw it, the European stuff, a lot of people have been moving between, say, France and England, or Italy and England. They want the same things that they can buy there in England when they're in England, because they miss them, you know.
Well, I wish I could move Fortnum & Mason here. I love that
Start
story.
One up. Yeah.
Miranda, again, congratulations on your performance. It is right on.
Thank you.
And I'm a Texan. I know when
I know.
I know when it's right on.
Oh, right.
And I'll look forward to the next time, whenever, wherever. Meanwhile, have very happy holidays.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You're dressed for Christmas already.
Yes, well, see...